where Antoine Wright had a very disappointing first half. He had no points here tonight. He only had 2 the first half up against Kansas, and then he came back for 13 in the second half of action there. He's doing a good job here tonight in the second half.
Don't forget, ACC Sunday Night Hoops returns to FSN this week with a doubleheader, beginning with 8th-ranked Georgia Tech taking on North Carolina State. Then Virginia battles 5th-ranked Duke. Coverage begins with a tip-off show, 4 p.m. Central, only on FSN Southwest.
Greg, another interesting score of note in the Big 12, the nation's number 2 team, Kansas Jayhawks. They are at Ames, Iowa tonight. They're tied 54-54 with about 5 minutes left.
Well, there's a long time Mr. Aggie basketball, Shelby Metcalf. He had some great teams here until he retired a number of years ago, and he is here in attendance, as he tries to be as much as possible.
Well, and I
can
tell
you, he was your old boss.
Absolutely. I was an assistant under Shelby Metcalf at one time, and he's one of the real gentlemen in the game, certainly one of the great humorists in college basketball. But what Texas A&M fans know, that Aggie basketball has never come close to being the same since he left.
It's got a good chance of being the same or better with the current regime. As a matter of fact, a record has already been set tonight. 12,811. This is the largest Aggie home crowd ever.
Well, people love winners, and Texas A&M, if they can hold on here, will be 12-1. I don't imagine this will be the last time this arena's packed.
And now they're into conference play. They had a good crowd in their game against Houston, and now you're into conference play. I think you're going to see some big crowds here in Aggieland. Buckman for 3. Buckman is on the board.
Nice balance up by Buckman. And what Texas A&M did right there defensively for the first time tonight, they were in a triangle and 2 defense.
4:39. Law penetrates, dumps it off. Wright fakes the 3, goes into challenge. Blocked by Aldridge. Nice play by Aldridge. His right hits the deck. It's a 5-on-4 momentarily. Polino swings it over to the deep right side, flying by, and Taylor hits. Taylor hits a 3.
Well, quickly a 10-point ball game once again.
And there's 4:16. If the Longhorns have anything left in the tank in reserve, especially hustling on defense, this is when it has to happen.
Now, the Aggies need to work now to draw a foul. They don't need to stop the clock unless they get a real good shot.
And they're going to talk about it. Billy Gillespie is assisted by Alvin Brooks, the former head man at Houston, Steve Forbes, Buzz Williams, Matt Doles.
Well, that's a good staff that Billy Gillespie has put together. Going to take a look at that last 3 by the Longhorns. Kenny Taylor's 2nd 3 ball of the night. You could see Antoine Wright running at him, leaving his feet. Another defender comes over, but Taylor took his time and nailed it.
He has 8 points.
Mentioned the Texas Aggie assistants a while ago. Rick Barnes has some outstanding assistants as well over on the Texas bench. Ken McDonald, Rodney Terry, and Russ Springman. And their newest assistant, one of the former Longhorn players, Chris Ogden.
Yep. Chris had an injury-plagued career, but he's going to get into the coaching business and see how that works.
Good job. Good shot right there of Ken McDonald talking to strength coach Todd Wright. McDonald's the newest member of the Texas coaching staff.
Aggies basketball. 15 on the shot clock. Leach gets it across the line. Now 10 on the shot clock.
Let's see what the Aggies do coming out of this timeout.
Leach beats the clock, tries to draw a foul, doesn't. The ball goes out of bounds. Off Aldridge, I believe. So it's going to be the Aggies ball, but it may only be 2 seconds on the shot clock. We're going to have a timeout. We'll be back to see what happens with those 2 seconds. It's 60-50, A&M.
What up, Terry and Phil?
Hey, Al, can we borrow your car?
Terry and Phil, Terry and Phil, Terry and Phil and your automobile.
Will they damage your car?
Of course they will, Terry. It's Terry and Phil.
The Roommates, coming this fall.
You know what? I'll drive.
You don't trust just anyone with your car. Why trust any company to insure it? Step up to State Farm. See your local Texas State Farm agent for good coverage at a good price.
Get ready to ride. The new 2005 Ford Super Duties are out, and they're more capable, tougher, stronger than ever, with more horsepower, towing, and payload capacity than Dodge. So, when Dodge says their truck can go head-to-head with Ford Super Duty, how do we respond?
Now that's a lot of bull.
When you compare Ford to Dodge, Super Duty is over $500 less. The next Ford Super Duty.
Ford is the best in Texas.
It's a Texas-sized matchup. Houston's got the hot hand of T-Mac and some quick feet in the emerging Bob Zura. But San Antonio's power player Tim Duncan is making the shots, keeping the Spurs near the top of the conference. Spurs, Rockets, Saturday on FSN Southwest.
The Aggies lead it by 10, but they've only got 2 seconds on the shot clock. Let's take a look at the situation now, set up some of where we stand, the foul trouble, and also the game summary. The game summary, Texas only 28%. Law with 21 points. Of course, the foul situation, Harrison, Pompey both out. Each team has lost a player. Only 2 seconds now on the shot clock. The Aggies, they don't get a basket here. Texas gets the rebound, and obviously, the Longhorns with a basket are right back in it with 3:44 to play.
Well, look for him to try to get the ball to Antoine Wright. Nope, going to AC Law. Not a bad decision.
Oh, that may be the killer.
That was unbelievable. Whoa. Right there. That was crucial. What a pressure player. That's Law's 24th point of the night.
And Polino travels, and that's killer part number two. It's back up to 13, and they've got the ball.
Well, Greg, I was just going to point out, before I do that, let's take a look at AC Law. 2 seconds left on the clock. Great pressure by P.J. Tucker, and all the sophomore does is jump up and over the long arms of P.J. Tucker. In the last two games, Texas has held Memphis the last 5 minutes without a field goal, held Baylor the last 7 minutes without a field goal. Let's see if they can apply that kind of pressure here tonight. Down by 13, it may not do them much good, though, with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left. AC Law has just been phenomenal.
Right with a hanger, couldn't control the shot, battling for the rebound, still battling, goes out of bounds to Texas as Walker and Wright were scuffling for the same ball. Texas gets it with 3:09 to play and 63-50. Here comes Polino. The Yankee crowd is up and roaring. 12,811 strong. Three-pointer, Polino fouled in the act. He's going to get the shoot three. The foul was on Walker.
Not smart defense there by the Aggies. He's going to have three. So
face. He said, I think I'll back this one out of there.
See, that's where the proper strategy took over as Jones comes flying through and he's fouled by Buckman. And that would be five, I believe, on Buckman.
Well, we're seeing an exhibition by AC most assist man in the Big 12 Conference. He has many assists here tonight. A.C. Law has 7 now for the game. That's a good jump off there to Joe Jones.
Buckman, as you saw in that replay, wanted to block. He did get an awful lot of balls, but he did not get the block, and so he is out on fouls. Potts comes in.
Joe Jones will have the opportunity to add to his double-double figures here tonight. 10 points, 10 rebounds. Let's see if the big fella can add to the Aggie 11-point margin. He's from Normangee, Texas, right down the road from Texas A&M. I still
marvel at his ability after playing at such a small school, but when you've got talent.
Well, we want to apologize for the, we can't do anything about it. Let's just explain it. There's some terrible weather moving through, and some of you have had some signal problems. As Aldridge comes in and scores, I don't know how much that may have affected you. We're taking a 30-second timeout.
Very nice move right there by LaMarcus Aldridge for Texas, making the good move to the bucket for the Longhorns.
Don't know how long you have, maybe some of you have been gone, but it's a 10-point game, as you can see on the graphic. The Aggies lead it with just 2:25 to play. Texas had a 2-point lead once. The only time Texas was led in the opening moments of the game, the Aggies have had as much as a 22-point lead here in the second half. It was 15 at the half. The game's only been tied once. It has been the Aggies really dominating the game. Texas has tried to climb back a little bit, cutting that 22-point lead down to 10. But the Aggies so far have not let them get any closer than that, and time is running out for the Longhorn fans.
It'll be interesting to see the strategy on both ball clubs as they come out of the timeouts. What will the Longhorn defense do, and how will Texas A&M attack it? You can look for Texas to try to gamble at every opportunity.
Joseph Jones with 11 points and 10 rebounds and 24 points and 6 assists for A.C. Law. And two big offensive stars. Tucker with 18 points and 7 rebounds has really been the lone Texas offensive star. And Leach is fouled quickly on the inbounds play.
Well, that's what you expect. Texas needs to stop the clock and put the pressure on the Aggies now to make free throws with 2:24 to go. That was the 48th foul called in this contest. It's just about evened up. 25 for the Aggies, 23 for Texas, and I've got a feeling we're going to see more here in the last couple.
Making that not the productive idea if you hit free throws. He's got 8 points, averaging just 4.7. The starter much of last year. He just started a couple of games this year off the bench. He's very effective, and he's got 9. It is 66-54. Foligno. And it's out of bounds off of Aldridge's hand. And the Aggies get it back with 2:19 to play. Their lead is 12. There have been countless spots here in the second half where Texas would have basket, would have been able to get it under 10 points, and who knows? But they've not been able to do it.
You notice the last time A&M had the ball, they fouled Leach quickly. They didn't do that to Wright because he's such a good free throw shooter.
Leach only hits 56% for the year.
Yeah, they're going to foul him here. Although he's going for the steal, Foligno does not get it and gets the foul.
Foul number 12, Foligno gets first.
It's been since 1981 a win over Texas, the last time the Aggies beat a top 10 team. As we pointed out before, the Longhorns, strangely enough, have never.
Rick Barnes has never lost in this building. His record overall is 11-1 against A&M. Of course, Billy Gillespie is just starting a record against Texas. Wright will get one more.
Greg, you saw that last graphic there at the bottom of the screen. Texas has won 21 of the last 22 games in this rivalry. So what a turnaround here tonight for Texas A&M.
It's 30-3 since the 89-90. Wright gets one out of two, and it's 67-54. Tucker. Taylor. Taylor cuts through, lays it up off the glass. No. Aldridge?
Yes, Aldridge. Nice and job by the big, long, tall freshman right there from Siegelville, Texas. He's got a great future for the Texas Longhorns. Just needs to get a little stronger and more physical around the bucket.
8 points and 8 rebounds for Aldridge. 4 out of 4 in his field goal attempts as he's been going on the boards for those field goal attempts. A minute 43 to play.
Well, it's been fun to watch both of these freshman centers for their respective teams. Joe Jones with the double-double, 11 points, 10 rebounds. Aldridge, 8 points, 8 rebounds. Both of them have had nice games. The downfall for the Longhorns has been their perimeter shooting here tonight.
The record is of maybe going to be set tonight. Best start for an Aggie coach, not the 19-0. To go down to 1915-1916, that's our old friend Tubby Graves.
Yeah,
that was the best
him.
Yeah, you probably did. He was the, that was his first year. And so this would, if Billy wins this game, this would make him 12-1, and that would be the best start ever in the first year for an Aggie coach.
Well, both these ball clubs have tough games coming up Saturday. A&M has to go to Texas Tech. Longhorns play Nebraska. And then they come home to play Oklahoma State.
Taylor with a foul. The only Texas hope here is that the Aggies are going to miss a lot of free throws, but the Aggies have not quit playing defense.
Playing defense, and so it's been very, very difficult for Texas to make enough of a dent because they are having a tough time scoring on the other end. Jones will be at the line.
Well, as Big Joe Jones, as they like to call him around here, Big Joe, I'm looking at this record crowd of 12,800 in this facility that seats 12,500. There hasn't been one of them leave with this margin. You would think in a normal game, they may be heading to the parking lots with an 11-point advantage with a minute 40 to go, but not when the Aggies are playing the Texas Longhorns.
Well, I'm told the weather outside has taken a turn for the worse. I don't think you want to leave. I do apologize. It's too bad that some of you are having some problem with the signal. Right now, I think Longhorn fans don't care much as Aldridge comes through and is in double figures now at 68-58 with just a minute 29 and another 30-second timeout. All is not impossible. It's just unlikely with a 10-point score with a minute 29.
Texas A&M is doing a good job of coming down and scoring after Texas scores themselves here in the late going of this ball game. A minute 29 to go. There's been many a 10-point lead erased with that much time left on the clock. Big thing for Texas A&M is to knock down the charity tosses. They are not a good free throw shooting team, only hitting 63% for the year.
It's 68-58 with a minute 29 to go.
Greg, it's important for Texas A&M to keep the ball in the hands of good free throw shooters. Naturally, they'd like that to be law or right.
It would be tough in this situation. They foul intentionally. That's the way the game is played. Crowd doesn't like it. Main thing for the Texas Aggies is to keep their poise. There's no give up in Rick Barnes encouraging his ball club now. Probably saying if Jones misses the free throw, let's come down and cut it to 7 with another 3.
Let me ask you about one of these Aggie players that's had such a big game, AC Law. Now, we saw him last year as a freshman, but it's a different role as a freshman. He reminds me a lot of Bernard King. Left-handed, good shooter. What's your comparison?
Well, I'm not knocking Bernard King, but I think AC Law is a tougher kid. I think he's a tougher competitor. He's a great creator. He's a good defensive player. You could tell last year he was going to be outstanding. We saw him. I saw him for the first time in the state championship game of his high school career at Dallas Kimball when they played in the state championship game 3 years ago.
69-58. Well, my comparison is really mostly offense and not necessarily full game, but he just reminds me. Taylor with a long shot way off. And Tucker has the rebound. Walker supposedly knocked it out. Bounce says, come on. A minute 11 to go. The Aggies are going to defend the home court at Reed Arena for the first time against the Longhorns. What a big conference win and start as Tucker has nowhere to go. Klotz gets the rebound out to Taylor. Taylor pops, doesn't get it. Rebound Walker. And Walker is fouled.
Well, you like the way Walker showed that aggression and came from a long way off to grab that cam. That's the walk-on, folks. Chris Walker.
What an important cog he is in this Texas A&M early success for this 2004-2005 season. Well, how soon do the Aggies start getting some notice? Tomorrow morning, perhaps. They're 11-1. They're about to go 12-1. Their early schedule, as we said, was not tough. But the last four games or so, it's gotten tougher and tougher, and they've now about to knock off a highly ranked team. Well, they may start at least getting some all-star receiving votes.
Greg, remember this. Their first two conference games have been against national top 10 teams. Played the heck out of Kansas up in Lawrence and then come here tonight and are very impressive.
Aldridge gets the basket inside. It also snaps a conference losing streak. This is just such an important way to get things
started. Way to get things started for the Aggies under the Gillespie regime.
LaMarcus Aldridge now garnering his 12th point of the night.
Double-double again.
His counterpart for the Aggies also has a double-double. That was a good feature, wasn't it, for us early in this telecast?
I made an error. He's not quite there on rebounds. He's got eight. Well, Jones leads the game with the fouls.
Jones leads with 13 points, 10 rebounds. Something we have not said enough about here tonight. We keep talking about AC Law's scoring, but he has six assists, and he's the conference's leading assist man.
Aldridge at the line. You get one more.
Marcus Aldridge was one of the most highly recruited players in the country last year. One of three McDonald's All-American freshmen on this Texas team.
-60 with 48 seconds left. And a foul.
Dominique Kirk, one of the outstanding freshmen on the floor. Chance to add to his totals here tonight. He has 5 points on the evening.
Kirk will be at the free throw line. They're moving the fans down. I have a feeling there's going to be some fans rushing the floor here.
Well, anytime the Texas Longhorns and the Texas Aggies get together, whoever wins is extremely happy, and certainly this crowd should be that way here tonight. This is a huge victory for Texas A&M basketball.
Kirk will have one more shot.
And you've gone 23 years without beating a top 10 team. It's something to celebrate.
Well, I asked Billy Gillespie when we talked to him earlier today about this Texas Aggie rivalry, and I'm not sure it totally it's soaked in yet. I think it will after this one. And the foul will be on Aldridge. And that'll be his fifth. Now they are happy. They know it's theirs. With 35.6 seconds to go, 73-60.
I'm waiting for Billy Gillespie to smile. Come on, Billy, you got it, man. Enjoy the moment. First Aggie coach to beat a big top 10 team in 23 years.
Waits at the line.
Well, as much as anything, the importance of this win for Billy and the Aggies is that it proves to those players that system and that hard work that he's put in, there's validity to it. This game's one thing, but 12-1's not bad either.
Well, he put him through what's called his boot camp, and He's so happy the way the players responded to his demands. He's a very tough coach. We had two great coaches here tonight, Rick Barnes and Billy Gillespie, both.
Well, Rick with over 350 wins in his career. That ball goes into the corner. Taylor for three.
Kenny Taylor's third three-point shot of the night.
Tonight's game is brought to you by State Farm Insurance, offering Texas-sized discounts on auto insurance of up to 20%.
27.7 seconds, that's it. Here in the State Farm Lone Star Showdown, and this is the basketball portion of it, the men's basketball. As we said before, the State Farm folks are sponsoring essentially every meeting between Texas and Texas A&M. In sports, and they're going to award a trophy of some sort at the end. And I'm not sure what this is about.
Referee's probably asking Billy, what's the quickest way out of here with these wild Aggies waiting to storm the court?
Well, it looked like a serious conversation, but then he...
Well, Curtis Shaw was smiling as he came out of that huddle, so...
Now he's going over to Rick Barnes and talk to him about something. Now he's going to go back the other way and get Billy and talk to him about something.
Well, this is very interesting with 27 seconds to go here.
Maybe that's it. Let's do the congratulating now and then we can get out of here.
Well, you said there's 27 seconds to go. The last 27 seconds has taken 5 minutes.
Well, but look at the fans behind the Aggie basket.
Oh,
I think that's what this is about. They say, yeah, they're going to probably come on the court. We better get out of here.
Yeah.
All right.
Greg, I'll protect you. You protect me.
15 seconds.
This is getting ready to be bedlam.
They're congratulating each other. And it's 74-63, and here they come. Oh, my.
It's neat, the students going over to high-five Coach Billy Gillespie. Is this what midnight yell practice looks like?
They won the state. I'll tell you.
Well, I'll promise you already Rick Barnes is saying to his group, hey, they've got to come to Austin later this year.
Yeah.
That will be an interesting rematch.
One game does not a season make, but for the Aggies, this comes pretty close. 74-63, the Aggies lead the Longhorns, knocking on off the 10th-ranked Longhorns, the biggest rivals by a score of 11 points. We'll be back in just a moment from Aggieland.
Hey.
Oh, sorry.
I'm working here.
Why does technology have to be so difficult? At CompUSA, we make technology easy. Easy to get, easy to use. CompUSA, you're on.
They say once a new car leaves the dealership, it starts to lose money. There's one car, however, that keeps its value far better than others. And if that's something that appeals to you, the Honda Civic is your kind of car.
After waking up at 6 a.m. Monday through Friday, what is it that makes a man get up at 4 on Saturday? Must be something in the water. Busch Beer, official beer of Bass.
Raise the flag, raise the flag.
Department Store, you can get a 100% wool suit for $299.99. K&G has 100% wool suits that look just as stylish for a third of that. K&G, for men, for less.
You're watching FSN Southwest.
There you see it, Jim Haller and yours truly, Greg Lucas, back here. They're still on the court. The players, some of them are still on the court. Never seen more people use their little photo phones to take pictures of this thing.
Well, this is a monumental moment in Texas Aggie basketball history, as we've said many times tonight. First win over a top 10 team in 23 years. But what we need to emphasize, this was the AC Law show here tonight.
Oh, sure,
the young
was.
Sophomore put on
well,
a
that's
exhibition.
The story. 74-63, the Aggies win it. Let's go now to the Southwest Sports Report for this and other stories from around the sports world in the region.
You're watching your Southwest Sports Report.
Coming up on your Busch Light Southwest Sports Report, the Lone Star Showdown switches to the hardwood. We go back to College Station for complete post-game coverage of the Aggies and Longhorns.
How are Dennis Franchione's Aggies doing during recruiting season? We get the latest from Bobby Burton of Rivals.com. Also, Roy Williams just finished a record-breaking season with the Lions. The former Longhorn evaluates his rookie season.
I'd have injured my ankle in the fourth, fifth game of the season. I think I'd easily had it to over 1,000 yards.
Now that Carlos Beltran is gone, the Astros turn their attention to a Rockies slugger. Plus, UT Dallas is a national power in chess, but their captain has had more than rooks and knights on his mind lately.
It was definitely difficult to have such thing happening inside when I'm playing a huge game.
Good evening. This is your Southwest Sports Report, presented by Busch Light.
Welcome into the FSN studios. Dana Larson and John Rattigan, your hosts tonight. And what a game in College Station. Storms wreaking havoc on our broadcast tonight. For that, we apologize, but that was nothing compared to the A&M storm on the UT Longhorns tonight. We are headed back to Reed Arena for post-game coverage coming up.
Also ahead, another Franchione is coaching football in Texas. We tell you who and where, plus some of the best high school football players in the country are in San Antonio. We'll take you to the Alamo City and tell you why. But first, college basketball.
That's right, the Lone Star Showdown, the 11-1 Aggies hosting the 10th-ranked Texas Longhorns. UT has won 21 of 22 against A&M first half. Aggies looking good. Freshman Joseph Jones playing large two and the foul there. Texas answering. P.J. Tucker all by himself in the lane. We're tied at 12. Late first. Aggies pulling away now. A.C. Law with a nice baseline runner. 30-18 A&M by 14 at the half. Second half, more of the same. Antoine Wright, three of his 8 points. 44-24 Aggies, but UT hanging tough, fighting back. Kenny Taylor from Sugar Land, a huge three. Taylor had 11 points, Horns within 10. Next trip, A&M inbounding. Only 2 seconds left on the shot clock, and Law does it again. A dagger three. Law led all scores with 25, and Reed Arena going nuts. All 12,811 of them, the largest Aggie home crowd ever, on hand to see this big-time upset. Texas A&M beating Texas 10th-ranked Longhorns, their arch rival, 74-63. By far the biggest win for new coach Billy Gillespie, who now owns the best coaching start in A&M history. The Aggies 11-0 at home this year, snapping UT's 10-game win streak in College Station.
Let us take you straight back out to the scene of the excitement. Our Jim Haller standing by with the aforementioned Coach Gillespie and a special guest. Jim, take it away.
Thanks, Dana and John. We just witnessed a monumental moment in Texas Aggie basketball. Coach Billy Gillespie, nothing like your first conference game beating a top 10 team for the first time in 23 years for Texas A&M. What are your thoughts right now?
I'm really emotional. These guys are tough, Jim. They're better than people have given them credit for. Texas has a great team. We're very fortunate that they missed a lot of shots that they don't normally make. But our guys were tough for 40 minutes, and I can't tell you how much I love them and how proud I am of them.
Well, every time I talk to you, you're bragging on this guy that you're hugging right now. Oh, he said it was the AC Law show tonight. AC, was that boot camp that he put put you through worth it now?
Yeah, it was very much worth it. That's what got us through the game today. See how tough them, they got tired, and we were able to suck it up and get through it and get the victory.
Well, you can repeatedly just penetrated the tough Texas defense all night long. Was that in your thought process going into the game?
One of the things we talked about in the pregame, we wanted to just tack them and keep a lot of pressure on them, and I was able to do it through the game, and we got the victory.
Well, Billy, you know this is a great victory, but I'm going to remind you, you're in the toughest basketball league in America. You got to go to Lubbock Saturday, but enjoy this one.
We're going to enjoy it, but we know how tough they all are. We're going to try to get ready to play and just see what we can do. We know where we are. We know where we want to go. We know how far we have to go to get there, but we're going to keep on trying, Jim.
Well, congratulations on a great job. Dana and John, back to you in the studio.
Jim, thank you very much. There may have been some naysayers after that 11-0 start, maybe saying a soft non-conference schedule, but after nearly upsetting Kansas in Kansas and now tonight upsetting Texas, I think all those naysayers